Welcome back to the Body Balance Media. You're with us in Tanzania. If you have not subscribed, please do so. All right, we're going to talk about the design procedures for a building foundation, step by step. A good design must not only be safe, but must aim to save construction costs, time, and materials. The following procedures should help to achieve this, and an educated client will recognize the importance of funding this work with a realistic fee. All right, step one, decide the location of columns and foundation and the type of loads acting on them. For example, we have deal load, live load, or wind load. On the building plan, the positions of columns and load-bearing walls should be marked, and any other induced loadings and bending moments. The load should be classified into dead, imposed, and wind loads, giving the appropriate partial safety factors for these loads. Step 2. Estimate allowable bearing pressure of the soil using the ground investigation report. This report should consist of the strength of the soil at various depths or strata below foundation level should be studied to determine the safe bearing capacity at various levels. These values are presumed bearing values from any standards or codes, or aka building codes, in the absence of a site investigation, are used to estimate the allowable bearing pressure. Let's jump into step 3. Decide the depth of the foundation. The invert level of the foundation is determined by either the minimum depth below ground level, unaffected by temperature, moisture, content, variation, or erosion. This can be as low as 450 millimeters in granular soil, but depending on the site and ground conditions, can exceed 1 meter, or by the depth of the basement, boiler house, service ducts, or similar. Step 4. Calculate the foundation area. The foundation area required is determined from the characteristics, loads, and estimated allowable pressure. This determines the preliminary design of the types of combination of types of foundation. The selection is usually based on economics, speed, buildability, and construction. Step number 5. Determine variation in vertical stresses. Variation of vertical stress, W.R.T depth, is determined to check for possible overstressing of any underlying weak strata. Hope you guys are enjoying going through these steps with me, and as we continue to journey through all the steps it takes to build a successful foundation, I ask that you like, share, and subscribe, and join with us. You don't want to miss what's coming next. We'll continue to give you guys education as we build and continue in our journey. So thanks for tuning in with us. Let's continue. Step number 6, calculate sediment. Sediment calculation should be carried out to check that the total and differential sediments are acceptable. If these are unacceptable, then revise allowable bearing pressure should be determined, and the foundation design amended to increase its area, or the foundations should be taken down to a deeper and stronger stratum. Yeah. You do not want to miscalculate this kind of sediment. Reason being is because the load bearing of each beam that is placed on each foundation has a certain requirement to hold up your structure. So if your structure is beginning to be shaky, or if your numbers do not add up, it is best to go deeper into the soil. Therefore, you can have a stronger foundation. I can't stress enough, foundation is key. So make sure that your numbers add up, that your sediment is accurate, so therefore you have a strong and safe foundation to continue to build, continue to expand. So with that, let's continue to step number 7, cost control. Before finalizing the choice of foundation type, the preliminary costing of alternative superstructure designs should be made to determine the economics of increasing superstructures cost in order to reduce foundation costs. All right, guys, thanks for hanging in there. We're almost done. Just a few more steps in this building of the foundation. And I hope that you're enjoying this as we educate each other, as we walk through step by step. But then most importantly, that you're enjoying what you see, and it also can help each of you in your building of your foundations. All right, let's go into step number 8. Consider time. Alternative safe design should be checked for economy, speed, and simplicity of construction. Speed and economy can conflict in foundation construction. An initial low-cost solution may increase the construction period. Time is of the essence for a client needing early return on capital investment. A fast-track program for a superstructure construction can be negated by slow foundation construction. The best way to avoid these types of problems in the building of foundation is best to build in phases, as we are currently doing in our project. So, I advise you to build in phases, and it helps out with the progress and the timetable of your project. All right, we arrived to our last and final step. Some projects may take longer, and some projects may have more steps. But in our case, it took us 9 steps to get to where we are today. So, step 9, variation and ground condition. The design office should be prepared to amend the design. If evacuation shows variation in ground conditions from those predicted from the site, soil survey, and investigation, it is best that you amend these and get to them right away. So, these are our 9 steps. And as we continue to progress throughout our project, we ask that you like, share, and subscribe. And I hope that you are enjoying what you're hearing and what you're watching. Let's continue to build. Let's continue to build back up Africa. Tanzania is where we currently reside and currently building and working on projects. But wherever you are on the continent, wherever you are in the world, be productive, be active, and be intentional about what you're doing. And as we are, we'll continue to build and build up the community around us. So thank you guys for joining with us. And as we continue to build, we hope to inspire and encourage you to do the same. If you would like to donate towards the Body Balance Ujima Community Center, please do so by Cash App. The information will be on the screen and also in the description. Till next time, see you all soon, and look forward to the next videos. Like, share, and subscribe. See you guys soon.
If you would like to donate toward the development of the Body Balance Ujima Community Center, please do so by Cash App at $ The Body Balance UCCG.